Next up, Martha is in Fargo, North Dakota, Real Presence Radio territory. Hi, Martha. Welcome to Catholic Answers Live.
Hello. It's good to be here. Thank you for answering my call. I've never been answered before, so this is exciting.
Well, we're happy we could be first.
Well,
go right ahead.
Father, I'm facing a little bit of a dilemma in my life just because, spiritually speaking, I feel like I've grown stagnant. And it's not that I don't know why. I know exactly why, but the problem is rectifying it. I'm a convert, and for the past, 3 years, I've been Catholic. But I had a life before my Catholic faith, and in that life, I had a lot of really unhealthy coping mechanisms, the ways that I would just deal with stress or deal with problems. And I know, being Catholic now, I know that those are wrong, and I know that God doesn't want that for me. He doesn't desire me to seek comfort in those ways. And I'm really struggling because I want to, I take a lot of inspiration from the Blessed Mother and our Saint Philomena, because they were able to sacrifice so much of themselves and just give complete surrender to God. And I admire that, and I envy it at the same time, because I can't even begin to, how do you even start? How do you, stop doing this thing that's worked for, so many years? And even if it hasn't worked completely, it's what helped you get through. And I mean, is there some method or way? How do you even start changing
those aspects
of yourself? Well,
first of all, it's a matter of being attentive to the Lord and recognizing who He is, and eventually falling in love with Him. By that I mean, practically speaking, I would suggest: do you have a crucifix? Do you have a crucifix at home?
Yes, I do.
I put it in a prominent place, and when you find yourself needing to cope, spend some time just looking at the crucifix, reflecting on how much He loves you and what He was willing to endure, and asking Him for the strength to be faithful to Him. Now, you may fall after that. When you go away, you may fall. The important thing here, though, is not to constantly chide yourself for falling, but to keep coming back to that crucifix and asking for His help again, because you want to love Him. You want to return your love, the love He had for you, to Him. You want to thank Him for the blood He shed, for the crown of thorns, and all the rest. The more you focus on Him because you want to be His friend, the more you want to be near Him, the more you want to be faithful and love Him, that's what you have. What has to grow. The other things will eventually leave, but the thrust of your life can't be on not wanting to do something. That's wanting to get your way on something. Keep it focused on Him, and you will get the strength that you need to overcome these bad habits. But the focus needs to be on Him. The more aware you are of Him, the more open you are to Him, the more you're willing, without even realizing it, the more you're allowing Him in. And the more He enters into you, the stronger you'll be and the more faithful you'll be. And never allow failure to make you stay away from Him. Satan likes nothing better than that. But the Lord will always forgive us if we're sorry. What He wants is our friendship, our love. And so if you focus on that on a regular basis, before you realize it, you will find that your habits have reduced greatly, and eventually they'll be in check. But it may take a while. But the point is, what you really want is Him, and not not getting your way in anything. You want Him, and He'll give you Himself more and more as you continue to do that. Does that help?
Is that helpful, Martha?
That does help quite a bit, actually. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
You're quite welcome.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thanks, Martha. Yeah, you are not alone in that, by the way.
That's for sure.
I think the whole process of a lifelong conversion is exactly what Father just described. So hang in there, Martha. We'll be praying for you, as will a lot of other people, too.